Take a tour of what may be the most expensive estate ever listed in the metro. In 1981, Des Moines businessman Ted Townsend built his dream home in Urbandale. Now it's for sale.
And there's no official price yet, but it would probably take about $10 million to replace the one-of-a-kind architectural wonder.
From the tree-lined street, only a glimpse of the house is visible, and that's the idea. 7 acres of total seclusion in the middle of the city.
It's not just a house, it's an experience.
Ibel Realty's Rick Wanamaker is known for listing the metro's biggest, most expensive homes. The Townsend Mansion certainly qualifies. A 9,000-square-foot mega house that looks more like a work of art. The living room, along with the rest of the house, is filled with custom-made furniture like these sofas and tables. It has a spectacular view of a man-made pond outside. The dining room is just a few steps up, right next to a state-of-the-art kitchen. Just about everything is covered with wood. No drywall here.
From the outside, it's hard to see how big this house is. It has 4 levels and an outside deck that's 2,600 square feet. That's bigger than most houses.
It does kind of blend in with the environment. It's sort of built into the woods. And most people don't even know it's here.
Downstairs, the Hawkeye fan has plenty of room to watch the game. And if that gets boring, there's always a huge aquarium filled with glass fish. 4 stories up, the master bedroom, one of 4 bedrooms, and the master bath with a sunken stone tub, one of 7 bathrooms. And to get to the master suite, Townsend installed a mechanical drawbridge. It's certainly a house with a sense of humor, along with a sense of style.
It's a property that will stir the emotions if you visit it.
So you might wonder, who is Ted Townsend? Well, he is the former owner and CEO of Townsend Engineering, a food processing equipment maker on Des Moines' east side. Now, 11 years ago, we actually sat down in that house with Townsend at his kitchen table to talk about his new project. At the time, that was the day he announced the beginning of the Great Ape Trust. Well, he's moved on from that now, and at 64, he says it's just time to downsize.